Hello everyone and welcome to the Clone Drone in the Danger Zone Level Editor tutorial. Today I'm going to teach you about Upgrade Bot and the things that you can do with him and his upgrades and the clones and all of that by continuing to build the adventure mode level that we have been building into over the last couple of videos. So if you want to understand everything else that's going on in this map, then the other adventure mode level videos are where you're going to want to start. Before we start messing around with Upgrade Bot, we want to make sure we know exactly what the player will be starting with. And we can do that by going into Make Challenges, going into Configure Upgrades for the level that you have, and selecting any of the things that you want to give your player, like a bow, flaming arrows, extra energy, weapons, whatever. In this instance, I'm going to make sure that the player has absolutely none of these so we can do it all in the level using Upgrade Bot. So by default, Upgrade Bot doesn't have any upgrade points. So what we want to do is add a skill point setter to determine how many upgrade points you start with. So if we place this next to Upgrade Bot, it doesn't matter where it goes, but it's easy if things are tidy. And if we go and put one in here, we will be able to, when this is triggered with an activation trigger, set the amount of skill points you have to one. So let's create the trigger that gives the player their first upgrade point. We're going to name this first upgrade. And this is the player use key trigger, which is a type of trigger that allows the player to press E to activate what it does instead of walking into it or the game doing it automatically. What we also need is a description up top so that the player can see what pressing E will do. And I'm going to write one upgrade point. And to make sure it does what it says, we're going to go into the skill point setter and tick first upgrade in the activation triggers. So here we are in the level. You can see the trigger right here, and Upgrade Bot doesn't think we've got any upgrade points right now. So if we press E, it changes and it knows that we have one upgrade point available, and I'm going to pick the hammer. Now, I'm sure you've all thought of an exploit of this, which is you go back to it and press E again and get a second upgrade point, which is exactly right. That's how it works. We have a second upgrade point so we can get a bigger hammer. And as a demonstration of exactly how this setup works, if I press E lots and lots, it doesn't give us lots and lots of upgrade points. See, we've only got one. Normally this would be a bug in our level, but I want to show you exactly the sort of problems that you're going to come up against when you're developing levels. So this one's a challenge for you. If you can think of a way to change this so that the player can't get lots and lots of upgrade points, then let me know in the comments. Would you use an animation? Would you use another trigger? There are lots of ways to do it. So that's how you set the number of skill points that the player has. But what if they're going through the level and you want them to collect them and slowly increase the number as they get further and further? So what we need is another skill point setter. And to make sure it doesn't change the number of skill points the player has to whatever is in this box, we need to tick isAddition. And that will add, on top of the number that they have, the number in this box. So let's test that out by creating another player use key. We can get one upgrade point from this, and if we press E a lot, we'll only end up with one. If we go over here to this secret area, we can add 10 every single time we press E. If we look at Upgrade Bot now, we're going to have 391 upgrade points, which is more than we need. But what do you think will happen if we go back here and use the setting function to set one upgrade point? If we press E here, it's going to turn the number back to one. Now I'm going to show you how to create a collectible upgrade point, because I've seen people doing this in their level editor levels, and it's a really fun way of letting the player explore your level. So imagine this was a secret path on the left here. We need to put a new skill point setter and put one additional point. I'm going to create a glowing cube for the player to see as a visual indicator of there being something special there, and I'm going to make it glow a lot. And because the player is going to walk into this, we're going to disable colliders, and that will mean that the player will be able to walk through it instead of bouncing off of it. And to make sure this does what we want, I'm going to surround it in the extremely useful AI trigger area and tick only trigger once. Next, we need to go into the skill point setter and check collectible as the thing that will increase the point value by one. And to make it obvious to the player that they have successfully collected this point, I'm going to add an animation and make sure that the play trigger is collectible. So everything starts when the player walks into this area here. I want to animate this glowing cube, but I can't click on it because the AI trigger area is surrounding it. So I'm going to click hide special objects just under where it says sections, and that will make it disappear. So I can click on the cube in the middle. And if you want to learn how to make animations, then check out our animation tutorial. But here it is, our collectible thing disappears when we walk into it. And now we have an upgrade available. Another very important function of UpgradeBot is to allow you to create clones. And you can do that with the clone spawn point. UpgradeBot is quite clever. So if you place up to 10 clone spawn points, UpgradeBot will automatically select where to put the new clones. But if you don't want UpgradeBot to decide which order they spawn in, then you can customize it by typing in spawn order, and UpgradeBot will place them down from lowest number to highest number, starting with zero. If you don't put the full 10 down, then that will limit how many clones your player can have. For spawning clones, it's important to remember that if you want more upgrade bots later in the level, and you want to make sure the player can spawn things close to where they are in your level, you should put your clone spawn points in sections that are in the same area as your player. So I've now put that first upgrade bot in section 1, which will appear when I go up here. We've grabbed some extra upgrade points, so let's get a clone. But what if I go all the way to the other end of the level? I don't really want to respawn over here. So we've got to make sure that we disable section 1 when we create a new upgrade bot. That will then use the clone spawners next to it. And if we die, we will respawn at the active section. But that doesn't mean we can't respawn at previous clones that we've created. So either you will want to maybe destroy old clones, or you can provide easy access for the player to get back to where they used to be. And that's how to use UpgradeBot. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. And next time, I will be teaching you how to load in extra levels into your adventure level using the level loader and level unloader. But until then, happy level editing.